What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Just a Guy on My Lunch Break. I'm Corey, and I will be your host today. Today, I'm going to talk about a little bit about my last video, which I touched a little bit on libido, kratom's effect on your libido, how disconcerting that can be, especially for males who may struggle with not only the libido, which is just getting horny in the first place, but there are other problems that persist with it as well, including maintaining an erection throughout a sexual encounter. Also, having trouble climaxing or getting to the big O, or whatever you want to call it. I'm going to touch a little bit more on that because I got a very overwhelming response. I think when you open the door to discussion about something like that, it's something that, you know, people are by and large just kind of embarrassed to talk about their sex lives, right? I mean, that's something private. It's just not something you really talk about. But when you open the door for it, I think it kind of empowers other people. And I had tons of people jump in the comments and, you know, raise their hands and be like, yeah, me too. That, you know, this happened. Kratom killed my sex drive, blah, 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 blah. I had a lot of people to, you know, to second that emotion. Also, too, I'm going to talk about my New Year's resolution this year as of January the 1st, 2024. I will be starting a taper again. I have learned to not sit here and say I'm going to come completely off of Kratom and I'm going to stay off of Kratom. I don't know what I'm going to do yet. But I do know that the amount I've been taking recently is not sustainable. I don't want to continue taking the amount I'm taking because it's too much. I'm not comfortable with it. Plus, one of the negative side effects is the havoc that is wreaking on my sex life. Not cool with that. Not cool with that. Sex is a beautiful thing between a husband and a wife. I'm not willing to sacrifice that aspect of my relationship just so I can stay high on Kratom. I'm just not. Again, for all of you people out there that are happy with where you are with Kratom, maybe you're not taking as big of an amount. Maybe this is not necessarily an issue for you, the libido, the sex drive, all this other stuff. And if that's the case, listen, I'm never going to be on here campaigning against Kratom. You guys know that. I think to each their own. I think each situation from person to person to user, I think each situation is different and has its own special circumstances surrounding that user. And so I'm never going to be on here campaigning against Kratom. So if I'm going to challenge, I'm going to put out a challenge there today because I'm going on, I'm going to taper. I may taper back to where I'm just doing it once a day. See how that works out. Because I'm okay with taking it, you know, as kind of a relaxant in the evenings sort of thing. And I will say in the past, when I was taking a smaller amount, like 6 to 8 grams per day of Kratom, I didn't notice any issues with libido, sex drive, you know, maybe a little bit. Maybe it took me a few minutes longer to climax, something like that, because there is a little bit of decreased sensitivity. But there's a difference in slightly decreased sensitivity that delays climax and literally not being able to feel anything down there. Anything. I could have had, you know, 10 of the hottest women in the world playing with my genitals, and it was just like bring, 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 like a freaking rubber band down there. Oh, Lord God, don't let me hear my wife say it. My wife is all I need, all right? I will never, it could be 100 of the hottest women. Does not matter to, what matters to me is my wife, being able to make love to my wife, and having a healthy, intimate sexual relationship with her, which I feel like Kratom is inhibiting my ability to be able to do that. So that kind of, for me, that experience was kind of the straw that broke the camel's back. I'm not saying I'm going to completely come off of it, but as of January 21st, I'm going to start my taper. I'll go into subsequently here. I've actually already started to tone things down, and I'll explain what I've done a little bit later on in the video. But I'm going to challenge you guys. There's been a lot of people since I started this channel to say, hey, if you quit, I'll quit. You know, let's do it together. Because, you know, one person is one thing, two people is another thing, but if you put a fist together, it's more powerful, right? It's not dissimilar when you put more than one person together, two people, three people, four people, five people, people feel as a team, people feel empowered, more empowered together. So, you know, if any of you guys, Vape Legend, I heard you, bro. I look at the comments and I listen to the comments. You said to me, you want to quit. If I quit, you'll quit. But you want to do a taper? Same here. I'm doing a taper. I'm not doing no crazy cold turkey sort of situation. January the 1st is going to be your time, my guy. It's going to be my time and your time to get this thing in a better, more healthy situation. Okay? I may end up quitting altogether. You know, it's one of those things, if I get to the point where I'm only taking it once a day and in the evenings, and I feel okay with that, and I'm not having any negative side effects like withdrawals and stuff like that, you know, you're a skip and a jump away from just going ahead and getting completely off of it at that point, right? Where I'm at now, I've got a little ways to go. I've been breaking my own rules recently. I've talked about this. I've been taking powder as opposed to the capsules. I haven't been weighing it. And I've also been guilty of taking it in upwards of 5-6 times a day. That is no bueno, son. With that, and again, I'm guesstimating. That's all I can do because I haven't weighed it. But I am guessing that I've been taking, for the last month or so, anywhere from 25 maybe grams per day. Some heavier days could be even more, to be honest with you. So that's just too much. Not comfortable with it. That coupled with the bad sexual experience. Yeah, I'm about to nip that in the bud. I'm about to fix this shit. So, anyway, I'll be putting out a challenge at the end of this video. If you want to join me in the Quitting Kratom with Corey campaign, you're invited. Let's put a plan together. Let's get in there. It's going to be different. That plan is going to probably look a little bit different for each individual person because we're not all at the same place with our Kratom use, right? And with that being the case, everybody's plan, whoever chooses to do it, might look a little different. So if you're not want to do it, if you don't want to do it, you're good with where you're at. Don't feel pressured. I'm not trying to pressure anybody. And I'm certainly not sitting over here on the other side of the screen saying, I'm going to do this. And for you guys out there that aren't doing it, you're somehow less than me, or you're somehow not making the right decision. And I am. And I'm uplifting myself over you guys because I'm choosing to do X, Y, Z. No. It's different strokes for different folks. Different things for different people. Some people have different levels of comfortability with it. And not only that, but some people aren't taking it as much as me, as often as me. So maybe you're not seeing these sort of negative side effects that I've been seeing. So keep watching my channel. No judgment here if you're continuing to take Kratom. I still want you to engage with the channel. Get in the comments, like the video. You know, if you haven't subscribed, please do that. That helps the channel as well. And I'm going to start by reading some videos, and then I'm going to talk a little bit about at the end where I'm at currently and what kind of challenge I'm putting forth out there, okay? This one is from at Florida Man Chowder. I've been mostly on Kratom for 3 years with some month-long breaks regularly. The last year, I couldn't break at all during taper, so I jumped off 6 days ago cold turkey. 2 days was definitely rough. Was in kickboxing and BJJ classes and just sweated like a pig. Good for you, my man. Good for you. Day three, back to normal, sweating and a little sluggish. Been hunting last few days, putting miles on my feet with heavy backpack, and now look and backpack and bow looking for boars. That's awesome. keeping my mind busy and body moving. Kratom is both a blessing and a curse for me. You too? You know, I think it's like that for a lot of people, my guy. I mean, that really sums it up in one sentence there, doesn't it? Kratom is both a blessing and a curse. You know, it is. And depending on how much you're taking, it can increase your mood, can help with pain for people who really need it. But it's also one of those things that is easily abused, and it's easy to get into that area of abuse with kratom. And if you get there, it's just too much, you know? And it's then that you start seeing those negative side effects of kratom, the negative consequences, the not being able to get your thing up when it's time to go, you know what I mean? That's not cool, man. Not cool. I mean, I'm 47. I'm not getting any younger, you know? And for me, that was definitely a straw that broke the camel's back. You know, I'm not getting any younger. So I want to have all the sex I can, bro. You know? I'm not ready to throw in the towel just yet on that. I'm not that old. Not that old. And I've shared too that it's definitely the kratom. I know that for a fact, because when the kratom starts to wear off at 3-4 in the morning, because it's been 8-9 hours since I've taken my last dose, you know, I wake up with morning hard-ons from hell. So there's no physical problem there. It is the kratom. It's kratom induced impotence. And I don't know if that's an actual term. If it's not, it is now, because I just made it up. I'm sure that's probably an actual thing. And I do know that there are other medications, even ones that doctors can prescribe, that are absolutely known for, you know, wrecking the testosterone, causing men to not be able to get an erection, delayed climax, just all of the above. Okay, so this is definitely a negative side effect of kratom. So hey, Florida Man Chowder, thank you very much for the comment. Hey, you're killing it, man. You went ahead and jumped off, did a cold turkey. I like what you're saying in here. He was in kickboxing, BJJ classes, sweated like a pig out here hunting with a backpack and bow. You got the right idea, my man. And to really get past those withdrawals, that's one of the main things that I preach on here. You're going to be uncomfortable anyway, right? The shit hurts anyway. Let's get real. But you know what can make it hurt a little bit less? If you just completely throw your whole fucking body and your whole being into the fire. You know, when you start going through those withdrawals, find other ways to really challenge your body and to challenge your mind and to sweat and to put yourself in that zone of just complete uncomfortability and challenging yourself, right? And something magical happens when you do that. You know, the withdrawals themselves, when you start doing stuff like kickboxing and BJJ classes and, you know, 6-mile humps, you know, with a bow and a backpack hunting for a boar. When you start doing stuff like that, that is challenging to you, the withdrawals themselves tend to be not quite so bad. You know, 3-minute rounds doing BJJ is way harder than the withdrawals. You understand what I mean? So it does kind of put things into perspective, and it does make the withdrawals a little bit more doable, a little bit more manageable as you start to put yourself into the fire of just uncomfortability, right? But anyway, keep us updated on where you're at, because other people learn off this stuff, my guy. Other people learn off this stuff. So thank you for leaving the comment, because people who are hearing that comment that want to quit for whatever reason it is, they're hearing that and they're encouraged by that. They feel empowered by that. Well, hell, this Florida Man Chowder guy did it. Why can't I do it, right? So anyway, at Jonas Ray. Jonas, thank you for commenting, my dude. Jonas is a guy who's been, he's been on board with me on this train ride of this channel since really the very beginning. I've known Jonas for probably, what, a good 6 months or more now. We've kind of become friends outside of the channel, and we, you know, keep in touch through text and stuff like that. He lives in a completely different part of the country than I do, but we just have a lot in common. Both of us very positive, encouraging mindsets, and you know, this guy's about half my age, but you know, I definitely feel a kinship with him, and anyway, and he's been supporting me on the channel, so he shared a very valuable experience with me recently in relation to my last video about the effect on sex drive and libido and all that, and I'm glad he did, because this guy's 22 years old, and what he says right here is an absolute stone cold indicator that kratom kills mother effing sex lives, that it kills testosterone, that it kills libido. 22 years old. When I was 22 years old, my dick stayed hard. 24 freaking 7 stayed hard. You understand me? I mean, it didn't take nothing but the wind blowing the wrong way, and I was like, oh shit, damn, you know? That's a 22-year-old man for you, you know, and this is a guy who has military background. He's got fucking testosterone in every orifice of his body, you know? So this guy sneezes and fucking testosterone flows all over the windshield of his car. You know, this guy should not be having these sort of experiences, but just check out his experience. I'm a good friend of yours, and I'm 22 years old, and kratom has hurt my testosterone too. I'm more tired, a bit more on the emotional side on things, and I have trouble getting it up or achieving orgasm the longer I've been on kratom. It happened with a new girl that I was really into recently and basically ruined things with us because it was our first time being with the girl. I never had this issue before. I would be ready to go all the time. My body has also gotten a lot more soft and less muscle tone. The longer I've been on it, and my ambition to work out has gone down. So don't beat yourself up too bad. The kratom hurts it a lot. And by it, he's talking about testosterone, sex drive, the ability to get an erection, the ability to climax, all of these things. Jonas, thank you very much again. You know, and I've already explained who Jonas is and why, when you hear something like this from a guy, you know, and this, listen, let's just get real. As a young man that age, and it's your first time, your first opportunity to have a sexual encounter with a person that you've not grown sexually tired of, you've never been with them before, there's already that anticipation and excitement of it being a new person, you're already really, really attracted to that person. He explained that he is really attracted to this girl, and he couldn't keep it up. That doesn't make any sense. You know, for a 22-year-old stud who is extremely attracted to a new girl, he finally gets to have a sexual encounter with her, can't get it up. So, you know, it's a real thing, guys. This is a real thing, especially with prolonged extended use. Thanks for the comment. And guys, you know, you younger men out there who are listening to me, and you're a kratom user, and this, you know, I mean, it's your life, man. Your life, your choice, you know. Don't let me tell you what to do. But what are your priorities as a young man? You know? I mean, I'm not saying that having sex, especially with just different people, I'm not saying that should be on the top of your list of priorities. But sex is very important for young. That there's a reason that young men this age have testosterone flying out of their ears. There's a reason for that. God made us that way. Okay, So it's completely not normal for a healthy young man this age to have that sort of experience. And listen, it's kratom induced. We know that. We know that, Jonas. You know, I don't know if the girl you had the experience with knows that. Maybe she'd give you a second chance. My guy'd be like, look, this shit right here, you know, hold up a little thing of kratom or extract. And this is what fucked me up, you know. Give me a day or two to get off of this shit and let's have another go at it, you know. But anyway, definitely not looking to make light of that situation. I know how disconcerting that is and how disappointing that is. But you know, you've always got my support, my dude. And, you know, it'll pass. It'll pass. Get with me on January 1st. You know, join the Quitting Kratom with Corey campaign. Join the movement. Let's try to get this thing down to a level where we're not having stuff like this happen, okay? At Living in Oklahoma City, official says kratom crushed my drive in the bedroom and almost certainly had a huge role in how my last relationship started a downturn. It ain't no joke. Again, another individual that's just coming right out and saying, oh yeah, yeah. I mean, it fucked my sex drive up. I'm pretty sure that's why my last relationship took a downturn. I mean, you know, this is real shit, guys. Real shit. At Michael Morrison, 9127, it did that shit to me, too. I felt nothing down there. I mean, example after example. Michael, thank you, bro. I don't know where you're at, but he says here, I feel nothing down there. That's present tense. That might mean you're still on it. Hey, if you want to change it, January 1st, join me. Quitting Kratom with Corey campaign. Why do I have to get on here and announce it? And I'm going to drop a little short on this too. I've actually already made it. I just haven't dropped it yet. I wanted to set it up first in my video and kind of explain to you guys what I'm doing. Why am I doing that? Because I'm putting the pressure on myself. All right. Because I have almost 600 subscribers, and of course not everybody's listening. You know, I don't have all 583 subscribers aren't listening every day to every video. I get that. But I have a fair amount of people watching and a fair amount of people that look at my videos and a fair amount of people that I feel accountable to, right? And I'm trying to put the pressure on myself by talking about doing a taper January 1st. And not only that, but I feed off of the support from other people. And when other people say, hey, I'll do it with you. Hey, me too, man. I'll do it January 1st. All right, let's do it. You know, I feed off of that. You feed off of that. You know, one person is one finger. Together, we're two fingers. Ooh, two fingers. So speaking of sexual stuff. stay focused, dude. Stay focused. But five of us together make a fist. You know, there's a reason that is a powerful statement. Together, we form a fist. We are more powerful together. So that's why I'm talking about this. That's why I'm putting it out there. People are gonna see the short, and and it's got music behind it, and it's kind of like a promotional. So people are going, why are you doing this? You know, why do that to quit Kratom? Why don't you just quit? That's why. That's why. Because I'm betting on myself, and I'm putting myself out there. You know, and I'm trying to get other people involved, because if I know that if I get other people involved and I get other people on board with me, I'm not going to want to let you down. I not only don't want to let myself down, but I don't want to let you down. So I'm inviting people. Come do it with me. Come do it with me. Because we'll feed off of each other and we'll get it done, baby. Shit. At Vape Legend 85. Yo, Corey, bro, if you quit, I'll quit. But I got to do a taper. No cold turkey. Yeah, I need to get back in church as well. I used to go. Vape Legend, thank you, my bro. You've been very supportive on this channel, man. I love your energy. I really, really do. Let's go, bro. January 1st. I'll kind of explain to you guys. I'm going to spend the last couple of minutes explaining to you guys where I'm at, because I don't want this to cut me off. That has been known to happen. But instead of taking it 5 or 6 times a day, yesterday I only took it 4 times. So I cut out one dose yesterday. Today, I'm on track to take it 3 times. I've only taken it twice. I took it first thing this morning when I got up, and now I took just another dose at lunch, and then I'm going to take another dose this evening, an evening dose when I go to bed, for a total of 3 times today. So the last 2 days in a row, I've left out one dose of what I've typically been taking. And I woke up about 4 o'clock in the morning this morning, and I was feeling it. The withdrawals were coming on a little stronger than they had before, so I could definitely tell that I have a little bit less in my system. But hey, you make the bed, you lay in it, no pun intended. And that's kind of what I've been doing. You know, for the past month, I've just been no holes barred, just taking as much as I want, and now I'm paying for it, let's be honest. But so I've already started to cut back, and my plan is, I don't want to be completely miserable through Christmas, though, so I'm not going to try to do a whole lot before Christmas and the holidays. What I'm doing is I'm getting it back to about 3 times a day. I'm just going to stay with the 3 times a day, get comfortable with that over the next several weeks, and then January 1st rolls around, I'm taking nothing but capsules. I got to figure, I might have a day or two of kind of figuring it out, to see exactly where I'm at, because I don't know exactly how the capsules is going to equate to how much powder I'm taking. Because like I said, I haven't been weighing it, you know. But I'm doing, you know, pretty heaping teaspoons. So I imagine I'm probably taking at least 5 grams or so each teaspoon, I imagine. I'm doing that 3 times a day. I mean, you're going to be looking at, you know, 15, maybe 15 to 20 grams per day. And then when the New Year's rolls around, I'm going to just do capsules, okay? So, you know, I might be taking 6 to 8 capsules at a time there for a few days so that I don't have really severe withdrawals. But once I get comfortable with the capsules and where I'm at with the capsules 3 times a day, at that point, whether it be January 3rd, January 4th, whatever, I'll start chipping back on the capsules, taking one capsule less every 3 or 4 days. And that's how we do it. That's what I teach on here. And we're going to exercise, we're going to drink a shit ton of water, we're going to go out and do healthy, creative things, we're going to take cold showers, we're going to eat bananas, we're going to take melatonin, we're going to take a bunch of vitamin C, we're going to do everything we can to keep the withdrawals as little as possible. So I'm going to start with at Boom Jitsu. Man, I hadn't heard from you in a long time, bro, and I'm really proud of you. I wanted to read your comment. I'm not going to get to it today, but I will tomorrow. So be looking out for that. Love you guys. Drop a comment. Let me know if you want to join me for the Quitting Kratom with Corey campaign starting January 1st, 2024. Subscribe to the channel if you've not. Like the video if I haven't already said that. Love you guys. I got to go. I will see you next time. Corey out.